And now we will learn a very advanced topic in sales tax, maximum sales tax. Why would we have a maximum sales tax? Well, in New York, clothing has a maximum sales tax as $100 per sale. The maximum tax on watercraft in Virginia is $2,000. The maximum sales tax paid on motor vehicles in South Carolina is $300. And the maximum tax on qualifying aircraft and jet engines is $2,500 in North Carolina. So you can see there are plenty of situations where we have to adjust how we use QuickBooks for this maximum sales tax. Our example will be sales tax on clothes in New York. Only the first $100 of clothing in one sale is taxable. Our first example will be very, very simple. Let's add a non-inventory part called clothing item to the items list. Income account will be clothing sales, and we can make it at the moment that we make the non-inventory part. We will leave the price field and description blank because we will put them in at the moment of the sale. From the main menu, click List, Item List. In the bottom left, click Item, New, and the new item window opens up. This will be a non-inventory part because we probably don't have to count the quantity. The name will be clothing item. Now, we will leave price and description blank. Of course, it's taxable, at least when we set it up. And then we will add a new income account. QuickBooks knows the type of account is income, and it will be income from clothing sales. Click Save and Close for the income account. Click OK to save the item, and now we can use the item in our example. Now let's imagine on March 1, we sold 6 t-shirts at $25 each to customer Allen for cash. Remember, only the first $100 is taxable. It's very, very simple. From the main menu, click Customers, Enter Sale Receipt. Now, we choose customer Allen, and we choose cash as the payment method, and we bring the date back to March 1. Now, the item, of course, is the one that we just created, the clothing item. We will put quantity of 4, and we, even though we're selling 6, on the first line, we'll put quantity of 4. The description will be t-shirt. And the quantity will be on the first line will be 4. And of course, the customer needs to see the rate at $25 each. Click OK. And we will leave the first line or the first 4 as taxable. Then on the second line, choose the exact same item, same description. And on the second line, put the 2 that are not taxable, even though they're for the same price. Now, if you leave this column the way it is, the total tax will be $12. But remember, the maximum sales tax you can collect on one sale for clothes is $8, 8% of 100. All you have to do is take the non-taxable line and change the code to non-taxable. Now, only the 4 items in the first line are taxable, and that's what gives you your maximum of $8. And the same items, but on the second line, or any other item that follows down in the receipt, will be non-taxable. When we click Save and Close, you can look at the sales tax report, and you can see, A for all, you can see that non-taxable sales have gone up by $50. If I double-click this total, you can see for the item of the t-shirt, this was the sale receipt on March 1, and it's $50 because that's what we got when we double-click the non-taxable. When we double-click the total taxable sales, you can see the same March 1 invoice to Alan for the T-shirt as only $100 of sales being taxable. Now, this second example is a little bit more complex. Four pantsuits at $40 each means that there's no way to arrange it to become an even $100. But the problem is maximum sales tax on clothing items is for the first $100. So if we only put two pantsuits, that's 80. What about the other 20? If we put three pantsuits on the first line, that's 120. And if we tax that first line, it'll be more than taxing $100. These are not priced items that would add evenly up to $100. So what do you do? Very simple, split one of the items. From the main menu, click Customers, enter sale receipt. The customer was Betty, she paid cash, and the date was March 3rd. Now, of course, we're going to choose the clothing item that we set up. And on the first line, look what happens if we're putting the rate at 40, because the customer has to see the appropriate rate. If we put 2, well, that's only 80. And then if we put 1 on the next line, that'll be 40. That's not right. If we put 3, that's 120. Well, what do you do? You can do this. 2.5 on the first line, making an even 100. Then on the second line, the exact same item, 1.5. And of course, the customer needs to see it's at the same rate. And then only make the second line non-taxable. If we leave the whole thing taxable, that's $160 taxable and $12.80 in tax. But if we make only the second line non-taxable, now it's exactly $8 because it's an even 100. Now, you won't always be able to do it this way. You might have to break it up more. Sometimes the numbers are hard to figure out, and it's hard to get a decimal number that gets you the even $100. So you could, if you don't want to break it up into decimals, you could just say two of these at 100, then you could say 0.5, half of one at 40, and then make this one taxable, and then make the other ones, the remaining 1.5 for $40, and then make this last line non-taxable. So by splitting it up across several lines, of course, you would have to type in the description, and you could copy it down the line, and you'd have to do other what we call workaround for these rare situations that QuickBooks doesn't have a special software or special module for. But this idea of splitting one and making it on different lines and changing the tax or taxable items in the right column is the proper way to do it. We still wind up with the right amount of tax. Total quantity at the bottom will be the same. You just have to explain to the customer why we had to split it, because only the first $100 is taxable. When we click Save and Close, we can open up the Sales Tax Liability Report. Push A for All. Now you can see taxable sales again have gone up. But you see it's split twice with the same March 3rd sale receipt. It says 80 and 20 twice for the same customer, but it's still a total $100 of increased taxable sales. And for non-taxable sales in this column, you can double click and see the March 3rd invoice has $60 of non-taxable sales.